wonders. It is like a gift to mankind which has enabled us to create many useful things. It affects our life in such a way that we are addicted to live with science. Hello guys, today we are going to discuss about one of the latest research going on in the field of science, which is related to electricity. Electricity, as we all know, is used in our daily life, and due to overgrowing population, energy or electricity harvesting is becoming a major problem in the whole world. Till now, we have been able to generate electricity through yet permanent as well as alternate sources. These alternate sources include wind, sun, tidal wave, thermal power plants, etc. But these alternate sources are not enough to generate required amount of electricity. In the present effort, through a small science film, we are going to focus light upon a phenomenon which are unknowingly using in many places.
Just wonder, what if we could generate electricity from almost all physical activities? Yes, this is true. Electricity can be generated by compressing and producing tension in certain materials. Such materials are called piezoelectric materials. There are many things around us in our day-to-day life that we use work on this principle. For example, alarm clock, buzzers, sensors, detectors, watches, microphones, gramophones, mobile phones, etc.
To understand the underlying principle, let's take the example of a quartz clock. Actually, there is a quartz oscillator embedded inside a quartz clock, which is a piezoelectric element.
We can see here battery, electric stepping motor, microchip, circuit connects microchip to other components, quartz crystal oscillator, ground screw for setting time, gears, tiny central shaft holes, hands in place.
Now let's see how the quartz crystal helps in keeping accurate time step by step.
Here the battery sends electricity to the quartz crystal through an electronic circuit to a microchip. This microchip circuit makes quartz crystal vibrate 32,768 times per second. Microchip circuit detects the crystal's oscillations and turns them into regular electric pulses 1 per second. Electric pulses drive miniature electric stepping motor. This converts electrical energy into mechanical power. Electric stepping motor turns gears. Gears sweep hands around the clock face to keep time.
As we know that pendulum clocks or simple watches vary slightly from place to place. That is, they tell time differently at high altitudes from at sea level and also as the temperature changes. Quartz watches solve all these problems and help in keeping absolute time because gravity and air resistance don't work at all here.
Now let us move to historical background of piezoelectric effect. In 1880, the brothers Pierre and Jacques Curie discovered piezoelectric effect. This was actually based on the observation that when certain crystals were pressed, they were able to generate charge on certain positions of their surface. But the term piezoelectricity was coined by German physicist Hankel after Greek word piezen means to press or squeeze, and electron meaning amber, describing substance that attracts each other when rubbed. Moreover, inverse piezoelectric effect was predicted by French-Luxembourgian physicist Gabriel Lippmann and was confirmed experimentally by Curie brothers. First serious work on piezoelectric devices took place during World War I, and first practical application was sonar.
Piezoelectricity. Finally, here we are able to define piezoelectricity. It is the ability of some materials to produce a voltage when subjected to mechanical stress in the crystal. Examples include quartz crystal, ceramics, etc.
Before understanding the concept and types of piezoelectric effect in detail, it is important to note that potential difference is very necessary for production of an electricity. We have discussed so far what piezoelectric effect is. Now, it's time to discuss the type of piezoelectric effect and its concept in detail. Piezoelectric effect is of two types. First, direct piezoelectric effect. Second, indirect piezoelectric effect. In direct piezoelectric effect, piezoelectric materials like quartz crystal, Rochelle salt, certain ceramics, some biological matter such as bone, DNA, etc. can generate electric potential when some mechanical stress is applied. That is, if you squeeze certain crystal, you can make electricity flow through them. One point should be noted here that electric potential we generate by applying mechanical stress depends on the sensitivity of the piezoelectric material. Now, let us move to indirect or inverse piezoelectric effect. In indirect piezoelectric effect, if a piezoelectric material is exposed to electric potential, it will deform depending upon the voltage. That is, if you pass electricity through the same crystal, it will deform itself.
Let us understand it with the help of diagram. There are two cases in direct piezoelectric effect. In first case, if we apply pressure on this crystal, then it deforms like this, and hence we get potential difference across the ends. How we get potential difference across the ends, I will discuss this later on. In second case, if we apply tension on this crystal, then it deforms like this, and hence we get potential difference across the ends. One thing should be noted here that the polarity in two different cases differs because of shifting of center of gravity of positive and negative charges. Now, let us discuss the case of indirect or inverse piezoelectric effect. If we apply potential difference across the crystal, then the crystal deforms as shown in figure. Crystal deforms both laterally as well as vertically in different situations depending upon the polarity. If we consider both cases simultaneously, then by changing polarity continuously, we find that the system keeps performing vertical oscillations or mechanical vibrations.
So, what is the cause of this amazing phenomenon? So, to understand, let's think of a crystal. That is, assume any solid whose atoms or molecules are arranged in very orderly way, having endless repetitions. The difference between most crystals and piezoelectric crystal is that normally crystals have symmetrical unit cell, but piezoelectric crystal doesn't. They are electrically neutral, that is, atoms inside them may not be symmetrically arranged, but their electrical charges are perfectly balanced. So, when you are squeezing or stretching the piezoelectric crystal, you are actually deforming the crystal and pushing some atoms closer and thus upsetting the balance of positive and negative charges. Hence, we see a net electric charges to appear. And when you are keeping it in a voltage, you are actually generating the electrical pressure. Therefore, they will try to neutralize it and hence deform the shape.
Hello friends, now let us see a demonstration of piezoelectric effect. What I have here is a normal spark lighter commonly used in kitchen. So what's special about this lighter? This lighter works on a very interesting physical principles known as piezoelectricity. Now we can see that as I press this trigger, there is a spark on the head of this lighter. Now I am going to disassemble this lighter to show its working principle. Here I have disassembled this spark lighter. Here these are all its internal goods comprising of springs, spring hammer, insulators, conductors, etc. But the most important and interesting thing among these is this small object. This is actually a piezoelectric crystal. When we apply pressure on this crystal, the symmetry of atoms is deformed, causing a bulge in the crystal. due to which potential difference is generated on opposite faces. I am using this digital multimeter to show you how the potential difference is created when we apply a pressure on the faces of this crystal. Now let us set this voltmeter to 20 volts, and I am going to place this crystal on this opposite face terminals of a digital multimeter. As I press, you can see there is a small deflections. So we can see that when no force is applied, the reading is 0,0. And as we strike the piezoelectric crystal with a heavy object, the reading changes and it gradually decreases to 0. Hence, we can see that every time we strike the piezoelectric crystal, some electricity is formed. Hence, through this demonstration, we want to conclude that whenever we apply a mechanical stress or pressure on any physical piezoelectric crystal, some amount of electricity is produced, and this can be harnessed in large scale to eradicate the world energy crisis. Hello friends, now let's see a simple yet very interesting demonstration about piezoelectricity. In this demonstration, I am going to use a very simple thing, this polo mint, very common amongst us. What I am going to do here is, I am going to tear this off and take one out of it. I am not going to eat it, and I am going to take a plier and place this polo mint between these tongs. And I will ask my friend to now please switch off the lights so that you could see this spark.
And I am going to press the pliers on 3 count. 3, 2, 1.
Had you noticed something? Let's take a recap.
2, 1.
These are the stills of that spark. Let's try to understand why this is happening.
This is a polo mint, or more precisely, an image of a polo mint. These are electrons present on the sugar crystal of this polo mint. When we strike this polo mint with a hammer, due to the pressure, the polo mint breaks and some of the electrons get released in the atmosphere, causing an electrical field. As we know, 78% of the atmosphere is nitrogen gas. When the molecules of this nitrogen gas comes in this electric field created by these electrons, they get excited and gain some energy. They gradually lose this energy in the form of the light that we see in ultraviolet radiation, and finally attain their ground state.
Now, we will know what has been going on in this field. Let's talk about some ideas which could be implemented in near future on large scale. One of the best implications of piezoelectric crystals is in harnessing energy at mass level so that the growing energy crisis can be overcome. Piezoelectric crystals such as lead zirconate titanate, barium titanate, lithium tantalate, sodium tungstate are the candidates for harnessing energy using vibration from the surrounding environment. Constructing special type of roads to generate electricity just by driving vehicles over them is the next big step towards solving the energy crisis. The system works by embedding tiny piezoelectric crystals a few centimeters below the asphalt layer. Such roads are called piezo smart roads. When cars move over such roads, crystal embedded in them squeeze and thus generate electric charge. These piezo smart roads can generate up to 400 kilowatt of energy over 1 kilometer stretch, which is enough to run 8 electric cars. This 1 kilometer stretch of road can generate enough power for 40 houses. Amazing, isn't it? Looks like fiction, but it's not. It is reality. Such experiments have already been conducted in Israel. Such piezoelectricity generating roads have also been proposed in the car capital of the world, California. According to an estimate, piezoelectric technology could produce up to 44 megawatts of electricity per year from 1 kilometer stretch of the road and meet the energy demand of about 30,800 households. With the advent of nanotechnology, novel piezoelectric materials have also emerged in the recent years. Zinc oxide nanowires are one of such examples. The piezoelectric nanowire have higher sensitivity and higher efficiency. For a small amount of pressure or stress applied, they can produce much higher amount of electricity. To give an idea about the sensitivity, let's assume that a small grid of zinc oxide nanowire generators are embedded in your clothes. The rustling of that clothing due to normal movements could be used to power or charge portable devices such as iPods or cell phones. They are so sensitive that even the turbulence of blood flow can be used to generate electricity. They are even sensitive to the pressure applied by a person while doing signature, and this can be developed as a tool to authenticate the signature. According to one such study, power density of zinc oxide nanowires has been found to 6 to 11 times more than one of the best known conventional piezoelectric material, PZT. Besides being more efficient and sensitive, zinc oxide nanowires are also environment friendly. The chemical reagents required to make nanowires are also quite economical. Thus, it is actually a green piezoelectric nanosystem which is also cost effective. With the future advancement in technology, it might be possible to generate electricity at a large scale using piezoelectric nanomaterials, and efforts are on in this direction. In conclusion, we all know about the worsening energy crisis due to fast depletion of fossil fuels and other conventional energy resources. Often, solar energy cells have been projected as the most viable alternatives. But think of a situation near North Pole, where sun doesn't rise for nearly 6 months. The solar cell would fail to generate electricity. Think of a scenario when days are foggy, as happens in winter. Think of a scenario when days are cloudy, as it's been rainy continuously over a period of few days, as happens during monsoon. The solar cells will not generate electricity, but a piezoelectric generator would work even if it is raining, as shown in the video clip. Piezoelectric cells have been designed to produce electricity by utilizing the impact of falling raindrops. At a time when it is difficult to get land for setting up thermal and nuclear power plants, it is a good idea to convert all the nation and state highway, railway tracks into piezo power plants without affecting vehicular movement in any way. Therefore, piezoelectricity is indeed a smarter, greener, and cost-effective solution to the energy crisis, which can be used to generate electricity at any place.